and welcome to today's video. Today's video is going to be a get ready with me. I actually am expecting a few guests at home and I thought of quickly filming this video in the process. Today's video actually is going to have me using a bunch of products that are relatively new to me or that I'm going back to after a really long time. Most of them actually are completely new to me. I'll keep telling you as we go along with the course of the video. They're almost all, barring one product, they're fully affordable, budget friendly, very drugstore. I've been doing a lot of budget content for you guys, so I really hope you're enjoying it. I feel like that's enabling you guys, basis the comments and the feedback I'm getting, that's enabling a lot of you guys to go out there and try new things without thinking twice, because they're just so light on the pocket. We all love that. You know what I just realized? I'm wearing an antisocial ganji and I'm expecting guests at home later. Maybe I should change. Okay, let's not make this intro any longer and let's dive right into this new makeup tutorial of fully affordable products. Okay, to start with, you know I never begin my makeup without prepping my skin. I have the all new Color Bar Selfie Primer Oil over here. I actually have tried this once so far, but I'm excited to go back into it right now because you don't really need much on your skin before this. It works as a primer and it does help your makeup last longer. And it's really easy to use with the dropper and then you just simply go onto your face and blend it with your fingers. Time to go into the base. Now I love doing my base because I feel like I really focus on it and I want to blend it in and I always pay a lot of attention to it. For the foundation today, I have selected the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte. This is a demi matte foundation. Actually, if you look at the back of the packaging, you get a whole lot of detailing on how it's buildable, how it can last, what the finish will be. I have used a different version of this in the past. This in particular, I'm very excited for because even though it is Pro Matte, it is supposed to be really great for most skin types. I'm a normal to dry skin girl, as you know. So I'm going to take a little bit of this, apply it all over my face and get into blending. I always make sure I spend that couple of extra 1 or 2 minutes on the blending to make sure that the foundation doesn't look cakey and looks as natural as possible. Okay, so as you could see, there was a sure shot lightness with my foundation when I was using just the L'Oreal Infallible. I clearly have tanned a lot. I've gone ahead and mixed in a little bit of the Lakme 95. There is a detailed video of this foundation review, first impressions and all of that on my channel. I will link it in for you guys. It's still a little bit light, but I'm going to take it as a challenge and work with it because we still have powder, bronzer and a lot of other things to go. So hopefully this will blend in, set nicely and it will look natural by the end of it. For the concealer, I also have a L'Oreal Infallible one. Again, I've tried different versions of this. This is the first time I'm about to try this. Let's dive right in, apply it on my under eyes. Hopefully the shade of this will match and will blend in nicely. I always go over my lid as well, just to make sure that there's a completely seamless base for the rest of my makeup. And I love how the doe foot applicator of this particular product is. It is absolutely beautiful. It's nice and wide and you don't need to dip into the product again. So in just one dip, this is everything that's come on my face. Okay, thankfully that concealer went in really nicely with the foundation. Now it's time to set all of this in, and with the drugstore option, I'm going in with my favorite, very affordable Maybelline Fit Me Loose Powder. I love this baby. Just a little bit of this on my under eyes and around my laugh lines always do the trick. Now it's time to go over to the face, and for the face we're going to start out with the bronzer. I've picked out something from Pose. I've tried a couple of their other products, but for the bronzer I think I'm using this for the first time. This is a powder bronzer, so I'm just going to take a little bit off it and go ahead and apply it on my cheekbones as well as my jawline. So this is seeming like a really nice and buildable powder. I like that about it. You can see the pigment instantly, but at the same time it's something you can do because of how the product is. You can use it for a natural finish or even a really glam one maybe, because it's building up beautifully. going over to the blush, and I'm kind of confused about this because I'm not sure if I'm supposed to share this with you yet, or if it has launched as yet, or maybe it'll be launched by the time I actually upload this video. I pre-film a lot of content. I have the all new L'Oreal La Barre blush, which is, I think, from the new collection. I've never tried this before. I'm really excited to try this because I know L'Oreal has a lot of really cool lineups for launches this year. I actually have been getting a lot of them pre-launch in PR because I want to try so many of them out in advance. And this is one of those babies. Very excited to go ahead and try it. Blush as usual, just smile and apply some of it on the apples of your cheeks to add a little color to your face. As you can see, this blush is pretty pigmented. If you look at it really closely, you'll see a tad bit of shimmer. So I'm not taking it all the way up because I'm really excited to use the new highlighter I have sitting in front of me. You know, I always do my highlighter like it's the second last step just before lipstick. So we'll go to that later. Over to the eyes now. We're going to go over to the brows first. This is the only product that I don't think belongs to the affordable drugstore category. What I have over here is a new product though. It is the Precisely My Brow Pencil from Benefit. I received this in PR a while ago and I'm really excited to try it out because I love their brow products. As usual, I'm going to start with just feathering the hair out of my brows and then go into the pencil with strokes and then come back to this to feather them out and make sure they're all looking unified. Okay, going over to the eyeshadow, I'm really excited because I discovered, I mean, I'm sure I haven't discovered this being the first or anything, but I found this really exciting looking, almost luxe looking eyeshadow palette on Nykaa when I was shopping recently. And it's basically from, it's from LA Colors, and this is what it looks like. What I really like about it is how it literally has like crease and lid and a few things written on it that could be very helpful if you're new to makeup, if you're a beginner, like crease, lid, highlight. I find that really interesting. We're gonna dive into this and I'm gonna pick some colors and actually follow the instructions that this palette gives me. By the way, for the eyeshadow, I also bought myself a new eye brush set from PAC. I think this is my fourth or fifth box. I absolutely love PAC's brushes. Their eye brushes in particular are absolutely amazing. Okay, first thoughts of this eyeshadow palette, definitely it's got some weight in there. You can see that the pigments were really easy to play with. It's buildable, so you start off sheer and then you build it all the way up. I'm not going in heavy because I was actually opting for a very natural, subtle glam look. As you can see, the inner corner highlights are really popping, so I love that. And the formula is such that it's not buttery, I mean, but it's sort of buttery, powdery, because they blended in with each other really beautifully, and I really, really like that about it. I will recommend that you follow the lid crease highlight details given on this. They would make your life much simpler if you're a beginner. For the eyeliner, I have some of these new babies kept aside. If you've seen my what's in my PR mail, you will recognize these. These are from Rimmel. I'm actually gonna go ahead and use a shiny blue one just to add a little bit of color to my look. Okay, so I love how there's a little bit of color that's been added to my otherwise neutral look. It might be a little bit wet at the beginning, so don't open your eyes too wide. Wait for it to dry down in about a minute before you go ahead and open your eyes. For the lashes, I have the False Lash Superstar from L'Oreal Paris. Again, I've heard a lot about this one and bought it online. With this, you have the primer on one side and the mascara on the other. We're down to our last two steps, and I'm very excited to use this highlighter palette from Makeup Revolution, which looks really exciting, by the way. The texture of this palette looks so delicious. I can't wait to dive right into it. I'm going to be using this one right here today. I'm gonna go ahead and take a little bit of the pigment on my brush, use it on the high points of my face. This is so subtle, I love it. is quickly buildable, but it can also be very subtle depending on how you use it. And we are down, oh I love that glow, to the last step. This one is from Maybelline. It's a matte lipstick. Okay, going ahead to apply this as the last step. Okay, maybe I like it. It's giving a lot of importance to the color on the eyes, so I think I'm kind of liking it actually. All right, so there you go. My look is ready. I really like how it turned out. This is a completely affordable drugstore friendly makeup look with the exception of the brows. But I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys did, please go ahead and hit like on this video. I will be listing down all of the products used with the shade details down below in the info box. So make sure you go ahead and check that. I really hope by now you've turn that subscriber bell notification thing on so you keep coming back for more videos. Thank you so much for watching this. I love you guys so much. Bye.